Hey everyone, Camila Gonzalez here welcoming you to Halftime with Camila, where we talk about everything Serie A. Hope you're enjoying this weekend's matches. I mean, everyone knows that Serie A has some of the best soccer in the world. But did you guys know that they're also killing it on social media? Let's start with my favorite part, the drama. Luka Modric recently took to Instagram to fight off some rumors that he was the one who reached out to Inter first. The post apparently accuses him of reaching out to Inter Milan because he wanted to play on the same team as his fellow Croatians. He simply dropped a comment that says, "This is the stupidest thing I have heard in all of history." At least he's honest. And that's not even mentioning all of the millions of followers that Serie A teams have been gaining. I mean, Juve has gained over 6 million followers since announcing that Ronaldo was joining the team. That's the power of Ronaldo. This is exactly what we talked about with the Globe and Mail's TV critic John Doyle, who sat down to chat about being an international soccer fan in Canada and having all of this access of information at our fingertips. Let's take a look. What can you tell us about what it's like being a soccer fan living in Canada?
Well, Camila, it's very different now from what it was when I came to Canada. And I'm sure many TLN viewers will remember the days. I came to Canada in the 1980s. And in those days, it was very hard to find soccer, to find even find information about soccer. It was so distant. It was Europe, South America. It hardly ever appeared in the newspapers. It was hardly ever appeared on television news. If you wanted information about soccer, you usually went to an Italian club or bar or a Portuguese club or bar, and somebody had a shortwave radio, somebody had information, they could tell you what was going on. It's where people went to find out the scores of games every weekend. It was distant, it was remote, but it created a kind of intensity that is probably sharper than it is now. Now in the digital age, with soccer everywhere, on so many channels, on television, with so much access through the internet, it's very, very different. And the major difference, I think, too, and one thing leads to another, and the amount of information about soccer is part of what led to Toronto FC existing and MLS clubs existing in Montreal and Vancouver, too. Canada was prepared, very much so, for those professional teams to arrive. And as soon as Toronto FC played its first game, I mean, you could tell that this city, this country, there were no strangers to soccer here. Everybody was primed and ready. And it's a better time to be a soccer fan, but it's different.
And now what do you think about, you know, watching Canadian teams play? How has that changed in the last few years?
The quality of Canadian soccer has improved. I think everybody recognizes that. I'm one of those soccer fans, and not just as a journalist, but even as a fan, I will watch any game of soccer. Like if I'm walking down the street, and I write about this in the book actually, walking down the street, not that far from this restaurant, and a small group of kids on a patch of grass playing a game, and they're playing intently, I will stop and watch. And that's the interest I have in it.
And why? Why soccer? Why now?
Why soccer? Oh, I think you would have to go deep into my subconscious to figure that out. But it's part of my DNA now. It's something that interests me, and it's always a distraction. It's a distraction from everything else in life.
Definitely. And now, if we're tying this back to Serie A, who are you going to be cheering for this season?
Roma. Having made the semi-final of the Champions League last season, I think Roma still has momentum behind it. It will be hard to pull past Juventus, but Roma is the team that I have intuitively supported for years and years.
Well, thank you so much, John, for joining us, for chatting about soccer, chatting about Serie A, and it was an absolute pleasure. Hopefully, we'll have you back soon.
Anytime.